I am an American soldier. I am a warrior and member of a team. I serve the United States and live the Army values. Hey, I'm... say that every morning, you know what I'm saying? If you still gotta say that every morning, hey man, you're doing something a lot more constructive than most people. So embrace the suck, all right, and get through it. It's not that bad, especially when you come out on the other side of that, you know what I'm saying? 100%, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know. But embrace the suck, man, all right? You're doing a lot better than most people, trust me. I know it seemed like it's bad, it sucked, it seemed like it's hell on earth. It is. You can do it. It's all good. Today's Veterans Day. Today is Veterans Day. Today is November 11th, 2024, or 11/11/2024. You know what I'm saying? So it's a great day. The energy is in line. Everything is just, you know, great. What can I say, man? It's Monday morning. I'm on my way to the gym. Whoop. You know what I'm saying? Do some PT. Whoop. I should have, for Veterans Day, I should have woke up a little bit earlier, like 2 hours earlier, but it's okay because I'm not a veteran. I mean, I'm a veteran, but I ain't a soldier currently. You know what I'm saying? So I think I earned the right to like sleep in to about 8:39. You know what I'm saying? Because when I get up, it's all business. It's all business. No jokes. But yeah, man, I wanna come to y'all today and give y'all just a little Army vlog, you know, about my experience in the Army, pros and cons, recollect some memories and stuff like that, share some funny stories with y'all. But yeah, man, today's Veterans Day, man. I would like to thank all the veterans watching this for y'all's service. You know what I'm saying? Enduring the punishment, the blood, sweat, and tears and everything that we endure to go fight for people's rights that could care less about us, man. It's like really, it's a testament to true service. You know what I'm saying? It's like selfless service. That's one of the Army values right there. Selfless service. That's the epitome of being a soldier, just being selfless, bro. So, you know, I'm proud to have done what I did. And I used the Army like college. You know, I didn't really have a lot of guidance as an adult, as a preteen, like getting into life. Like I knew I was talented. I knew I could do a bunch of different things, but it wasn't until I got to the Army that I learned how to apply my skill set, how to really like break something down and, you know, build it back up essentially. So yeah, I'm grateful for that, man. Like it was, my time in the Army was rough, but it definitely made me a better person, you know, definitely. So, man, enough with the small talk. I'm not going here and I was about to say hit this back, blow this back up. I was about to say so many different things, but like with the whole Diddy situation, it's like you can't even speak. But let's try this. I'm about to go in here and endure a very, very, very rigorous. I am tripping today. I'm about to go in here and enjoy a very rigorous workout on my back. Wait, that don't even sound right. I'm about to go in here and do back exercises, literally back, at a really intense pace. That's the best way I could put it. That's the safest way. So I'm gonna go in here and enjoy a good back day. All right, and I might show y'all a little shit, but I'm gonna go here and enjoy back day. And when I get back, we on the shenanigans. So I changed it from back day. Now it's chest. All right. Big shout out to the basic training squad, the death troopers. If you know, you know. Check me out. It's one of the best basic hoodies ever made. Designed by yours truly. Come on now, shout out to all my battle buddies. Happy Veterans Day, y'all. My partner right here with me, he's keeping me company, talking about pancakes. But he's really talking about these power waffles right here. Right here? Hold on. These right here? After a workout? Man. Whoa. Look, these with some eggs. Man, come on now. I ended up in the military because I was in college, had the whole college trajectory going for me. And I was just a shit bag. I was a shithead, you know. Wanted to transfer, but didn't really want to go back. I said I wanted to transfer, but I really wanted to be out of school. So, anyway, tried to transfer. Some funky stuff ended up happening with my transcript. Couldn't get into to new school in time. So, just had to play the waiting game. Got stuck in limbo. And I was in my hometown of Durham, so I'm seeing all my old friends, and we doing all the old shit that we used to do. My mama looking at me like, "Yo ass ain't going nowhere, nigga." She suggested that I go exercise the military route. And I said, "I ain't going to no military. I'm too good for that shit. I'm too talented. I'm too whatever, whatever, whatever. I'm not going. I'm, you know." Look at me. Look at me now, a veteran. That's how I got there. She kind of pushed me in that direction. And then I told myself I won't go in. And then my cousin was like, "Hey, man, I can support you, but I can't support you being a bum. I can support you on your way up, but I can't support you just not doing shit." So, and I was staying with him doing some couch surfing. I was just very unstable at the moment. I was looking at CDLs. I was looking at a lot of different things, but I chose to go with the military. And I don't think that was a coincidence, because all of the men in my family that went on to accomplish something really significant and spectacular. They started in the military. So I'm like, well, epigenetically, I felt like the decision was already made for me. I just had to follow that path and find myself, you know? But I was there for it. Like, I really loved the military until I didn't. And then once I didn't, I found my way out. But I feel like it helped me, man. It helped me a lot. I understand the process of things. I understand. I just understand things on a deeper level. You know, I made a bunch of cool friends out there. My boy Godin, my boy Tillman, Preen, Boykin. If I forget your name, it's all love. You know, I ain't even seen no OCPs, and I can't tell you how long. So that was just the people that's coming off the top of my mind right now. But yeah, it definitely helped shape who I am today. You know, as far, because I'm very disciplined. I'm very, like, go-get-it mentality. And I think I got a lot of that from the military. Like, I had it before the military, but it was in spurts. You know what I'm saying? Like, it would be a little bit here, a little bit there, a little bit there. But now it's like more consistent, more linear, more efficient. You know, I'm piercing through now. You see what I'm saying? So I can attribute that to the military, mental focus, mental clarity, just understanding why it's important to do certain things, why it's important to run in the morning, why it's important to make up your bed in the morning, why it's important to wake up early in the morning. You get what I'm saying? Overall, man, all I can say is if you are somebody that is contemplating going to the military, just get as much information as you can, all right? And if you already pretty much got your mind made up and you're talking to the recruiter, tell the recruiter to tell you the cons of the military. Anybody could sell you on the pros, right? Tell them the downsides of the military, and you talk to each branch. Talk to Army, Air Force, Marines, Coast Guard, whoever, all right? Like, just make sure you find the right fit for you and know why you're doing it, bro. Don't just be out there, you know why you're doing it. Have a reason to be doing what you're doing, you know? Because if you know your goal, it'll be easy to put up with the debauchery. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a lot of that in there. It's a lot of debauchery. So just know, you know what I'm saying? If you know somebody that's been in, if you know a veteran, use them as a resource. You know, comment any questions you got about the military under this video, man, and I'll respond to you and answer your question. A funny story real quick. When 9/11 happened, that was 2001. I was like three years old, maybe like 3.5. And I see everything happening on TV, and I see all the military and the coast, the National Guard that they deployed and everything. And I'm like, Mom, I gotta go help my coworkers. Because I was like obsessed with the military at this point in time. I was 3 years old, so it was already kind of chosen for me, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I did it. It wasn't just, I'm broke, I need some money, I'm gonna go to the military. No, like, I really wanted to do it ever since a kid. But then to get there and find out it's not everything I thought it was, and people are crooked, and you know, that whole part, like, that was a eye-opening experience in itself. But that was my experience, you know. So cat luck ain't dog luck, dog luck ain't cat luck. You could go and you could have a totally different experience, and I hope you do, because the military is great, but the people there make it not great, you know. So if you can survive that, man, the military not a bad place. You feel me? It's actually one of the best places to be. if I must say so myself, it really is. But I'm about to go get me some good old free food. Food tastes better when it's free. Be right back. Came to get our free meal. Well, one of our free meals for Veterans Day. We've been sitting here for like 40 minutes. We ordered our food 45 minutes ago. You know what I'm saying? Look, I'm indifferent. But I'm a little pissed, only because I haven't ate anything all day, but more to come, so I'll let you know how it goes at the next part, or I'll let you know when we get our food.
1 hour later. Much, much later.
It's still no food. These people next to us, they got their food. He's crusty ass. He got his food. These couple behind us got their shit. But I serve his country, though. We've been waiting so long. Look.
Baby girl is tired now.
We didn't have to get up, walk around.
It's been about 45
years. Yeah, I was gonna vlog us eating the food at the second spot, but it was too good. Buffalo Wild Wings, it took like 10 minutes for the food to come out. It was bussing. Good little wing combo with a drink, you know. The drink was water.
Red, Jordan.
Oh! You hear that? That's the sound of sleepy kids. Gotta love it. You know, I told myself I wasn't gonna vlog while the kids crying, but figured I just gotta keep it real with y'all. This is what I be dealing with, you know what I'm saying? I love it. I do. Well, that was a good Veterans Day vlog.
Successful, but at, or no.
It wasn't successful
at first.
It was just like the military. We had to embrace the suck.
Definitely.
And at the end of the day, we ate for free twice. Okay. I'm about to go grab a little dessert. I don't know why he crying. But yeah, we about to go get a little sweet tooth situation. Head to the crib. I got the itis.